Hello students of class 10, welcome to my next online class. So this is the continuation video on the chapter household circuit. So in this video we'll continue where we have left, right? So here we will discuss what is house wiring system, what are the house circuit. Now which one we prefer tree circuit or ring circuit, or tree system or ring system, right? So which one is cost effective, which one is expensive, which one is cheap, right? So this type of circuits we use in our home. So which one we'll prefer? Okay, so that one we'll see. Now purpose of switch, why we use switch, where it is connected, right? And what are the safety precaution of switch, as well as double switch, safety fuse. So fuse, why we use fuse in our home? Now if you don't put fuse, if you replace the fuse with MCB, then whether it is cost effective or it is expensive, right? So what are the different functions, how it is made, earthing, why earthing is required in our home? If we don't do earthing, then what will happen, right? And here the three pin plug plugs which we use in our socket, in our board, right? So what are the three different legs of that three pin plug indicates, right? We see the links. Next, socket, safety precautions of electricity. Okay, so how while dealing with the electrical circuits, so what precaution we should take, and what are the color coding of different wires? Different color indicates different meaning of different wire, right? So for we know there are three types of wire in one transmission line. There are earthing, neutral and live. So which color indicates live, which color indicates earthing and neutral, right? So stay tuned, watch the video till the end, and don't forget to subscribe my channel.
As per new reduced syllabus from household circuit, some topics has been removed. So this is the current syllabus of household circuit. So these topics will be reading here, and I will tell you which topics has been excluded from the syllabus, right? Like house wiring system, this is excluded from the syllabus, you don't have to prepare. But from surface, just I will explain what is grid system. So it is a system which is used at the power generating stations, which is used to increase or step up the power and step down till it is being consumed by the consumer. Okay, then this power is being transmitted over long distances at higher voltage. So there is a reason why we are transferring this power which is generating at station at higher voltage, because when you supply at higher voltage, less current will be flowing through the wire, and we know heating effect is given by I square RT, right? Where I is the current and H is the heating effect, Joule's heating effect. So if less current is passing through the wire, then there will be less transmission loss, or we can say that there will be less leakage of energy. Okay, heat energy will be reduced there. So from here, main thing you have to remember that electric power is generated at 11 kilovolt. Okay, now why it is generated at 11 kilovolt? Because voltage higher than this can cause an insulation problem, and lower than this voltage, that is 11 kilovolt, there involves a current, and due to current there will be a heating effect. So this is the grid system. Okay, so how the power is generated at power station, then slowly it is being stepped up, that means the power has been increased by the grid system, and eventually it gets reduced till we consume in our home or in our city. So this topic was not there in the syllabus. Here you will see that house wiring system is omitted, right? So we can omit this one. Next we have house circuit. So this is included in our syllabus, you have to go through this topic. In house circuit, you see the cable which we use in our home for the transmission of electric current. So there are three wires in that cable. So first one is called neutral, live and earth. So these are the three wires which is being included in that cable. This live wire carries the main current, so it is also called the phase wire, and this earth and neutral where they are in contact with each other at local substations which are at same potential. So E and L, this denotes by earthing, neutral and live, and this live wire always carries the current, right? So in the live wire we will see that a fuse is always connected with live wire, a switch is always connected with the live wire, not in neutral nor in earth. This tree system is omitted from the syllabus. Okay, so in a tree system generally it has been seen that a parallel line are drawn from the distribution box. If you have three fans and two tube lights, that means there will be five connections made to the distribution box. So in tree system it has been seen that it is very cost effective. So number of wiring will be more, so the cost of this system will be more, and all the fan, light, these all are connected in parallel to each other, because if one is getting affected, other will not get harmed. Okay, so one question comes from here, generally here, why parallel connection is made in household circuit? So the reason is here. The reason for parallel connection is that if any of the appliances blows off, the electric supply to the other appliance does not get affected and they work properly at same voltage. That means if one fan is not working in a room, particular room, so other four connections will be working properly. Okay, so because of one appliance, other will not get affected. So tree system, just the basic part you will just read for your knowledge, and from the syllabus this has been removed. Ring system is also removed. In a ring system as compared to tree system, ring system is preferred most these days, because the cost is being reduced, the wiring cost gets reduced, and the connection becomes very compact. So this was the ring system. Advantages of ring system over tree system. So as per appliances has its own fuse in case of short circuit, only a particular appliance is affected without affecting other appliance in the circuit. So a fuse is connected in the ring system with every appliance, not a one fuse is connected with all the appliances. So if one appliance is not working, then that particular appliance will only get switch off, other will get keep working. Okay, so I'm not going much detail because this ring system and tree system has been omitted from the syllabus. Next we have switch. This is included in the syllabus. Switch is there, right? So switch, what is the main purpose of switch? Switch is used to make and break circuit. If you want to switch on and off, so we use this, right? So switch can be shown as a symbol like this. This is closed switch, right? And when it is dot is not given between the bracket, then we say the switch is open. Or else we can show by this way also. Okay, this is a tap switch. So if you tap here, then the circuit will become closed, right? This is on and this is off. So the main purpose of switch is to make or break circuit. It is used in switching on or off. So switch can be of single pole, which is being fixed in the particular appliance to start or stop the flow of current in that appliance, or it can be double pole switch, which is connected in the main distribution board, okay, to switch off or on the main. Now in single pole switch, when it is disconnected, the live wire also gets disconnected. That means it carries no current in that appliance. In double pole switch, when it is disconnected, it disconnects live as well as neutral wire. Now where a switch is being connected in the circuit, a switch is always connected with the live wire, because the live wire is also called the phase wire which carries the current. Now if you connect the switch in any other two wires like neutral or the earth, right? So if excessive current is passing through the circuit, then you may get a fatal shock. Okay, so always the switch is being connected with the live wire to discontinue the flow of current. As we know, the phase wire or the live wire only carries the current, so we have to place the switch in the live wire, not in neutral nor in earth. So what are the precautions we should keep in our mind while using a switch? We should not touch a switch with wet hands, otherwise you may receive a fatal shock due to conduction of electric charge. So whenever you are doing any work in the electrical circuit, make sure that you are using the insulator. Okay, the insulation should be there proper, otherwise you may get a fatal shock. And this is double switch, or it is also called staircase switch, right? When one lamp is to be controlled by two switches placed at two different positions, as in staircases, the ordinary type of switches are not used here. Okay, so whenever one appliance is being controlled from two ends, we use this double switch, or it is also called as stair switch. Fuse. So this is very important topic. So maximum time the questions generally comes from here. So what is fuse? So fuse is an electrical device which is used to control excessive flow of current. The fuse wire is made up of alloy of lead and tin, right? So which has high resistivity and low melting point. The wire is having low melting point because whenever an excessive current flows through the circuit, it will hit the wire, and due to its low melting point, due to this property, the wire will get melted soon, and due to its melting, the circuit will become off, right? And this will save from damage that can be avoided. Okay, so from here question comes, what is fuse? First of all, so fuse is an electrical device which is used to control the excessive flow of current. So what is switch is made up of? Switch is made up of alloy of lead and tin, which has high resistivity and low melting point. So how does it work? When an excessive current passes through that wire, due to its high current, the wire will get melted soon, and this will break the circuit. Okay, so this is the safety fuse. So live wire is connected between here, between these two poles, and it is being holded between two holder, like one holder and one against socket. So these are the metallic terminals. Okay, so this, when it is inserted, this gets fixed. Why fuse is always connected to the live wire? The answer to this question is in this paragraph. So we connect fuse with live wire because the live wire or the phase wire carries out the current. It is only the wire which brings the current in the circuit. Now if fuse is not connected with the live wire, or if it is connected to other two wires, or neutral or earth, then the excessive flow of current cannot be controlled. Okay, thus the appliance is the safe from getting damaged by heavy current. But if you connect this fuse with other wire, earth or neutral, the appliance will get damaged if excessive current is passing through the circuit. In a house, when it is found that one of your appliance is getting switched off, or if you check its fuse, if it is blown, then the first step we should remember, we have to switch off or turn off the main switch. Okay, because if we turn on the main switch, then other appliances will not get hampered. A thin wire of 5 ampere rating is being used for lighting lights and fan. That means here, if you want to run a geyser or air conditioner, then you have to use a thick wire which has high current capacity of 15 ampere. But to lit a light and fan of low voltage, then you just require a thin wire having a current carrying capacity of 5 ampere. This is called the current rating of a fuse. Okay, the wire which is we are using in a fuse, that depends on what type of appliances you are running. Safety and precautions. It saves electrical appliances from getting damaged, so this is one advantage. It saves us from getting a fatal shock in case of electrical appliances defective. It saves us and our house from fire due to over-circuiting. And it is always useful when it is connected to the live wire. And it should have an appropriate rating. Means what appliances or what carrying capacity devices you are using here. In our CD player, DVD, television or any other electronic appliances, we also find their fuse. That fuse is called as a cartridge fuse. A cartridge fuse is used which is enclosed in a thin cylindrical glass tube. So the diagram you can see in your screen, this is the cartridge tube and it is being soldered on the both side of the metallic caps. So this is being used in the electronic devices. So the purpose is same, it's also make or break the circuit, right? Whenever any excessive current is passed through this fuse, it will get melt soon and it will save the device from getting further damage. On replacement, now there's a other type of fuse is called MCB, that is called miniature circuit breaker. So miniature circuit breaker purpose is same as that of fuse, but if a fuse is getting blown off, you need to call your electrician to replace that old fuse, right? But MCB, nowadays we don't call any electrician to replace the fuse, rather we use MCB, which is used as automatic cut off the current from the main supply. That means whenever an excessive current is passed in your home circuit, then it will automatically get turned off, and when the current will get less fluctuated, it will come back to its original position. Okay, so this MCB, miniature circuit breaker, is based upon electromagnetism and it protects the entire circuit and appliances against short circuiting and overloading. This is the earthing. Earthing is required for each and every house. So this earthing prevents shock due to leakage or short circuiting. So sometimes we see that in our desktop, when we touch the CPU or UPS, we get a certain shock. So if your house, if you don't have an earthing in your house, then this incident we see generally, like we get a shock. But if earthing is made properly in our house, then we don't get any shock, okay, due to this leakage of current. In a 3-pin plug you see here, this is the earthing, right, which carries the extra charge to the ground. So what is short circuit? Short circuit is a condition in which a live wire comes in direct contact with the neutral wire and excessive current flows in the circuit. Okay, like when a phase wire and neutral wire, when they get connected, so that position is called short circuiting. And when a large current passes through the circuit and which causes the overheating, as we know, if more current is passed through a coil or any circuit, the circuit will get heated up due to Joule's heating effect, and that condition is said to be as overloaded. So the short circuiting and overloading can be avoided by using MCB. When excessive current flows through the live wire, it will pass to the earth, through the earth wire, if there is local earthing. Otherwise, it may cause a fire due to overheating of the live wire. This is the reason why we use earthing in our home. 3-pin plug, earth wire, this is connected with phase wire, and this is for neutral. So from this topic, there are few questions which has been asked frequently. Like why the earth plug is made longer. So earth leg is made longer so that the earth connection is made first. So first, if any leakage is there, extra charge, that will pass through the ground. And why this leg is made thicker than that of live wire and neutral? Because if this will be of same diameter, same thickness, then by mistake we can insert in the live wire. The earth wire can be inserted in the live wire. socket. Okay, so to avoid that one, we use this one as longer and thicker as compared to live and neutral. So this is the socket. So in a board, we have a switch and three holes. So this one already I have explained. This is the earth pin hole, this is a neutral pin and the live pin. So as compared to the radius or the diameter of this earth pin hole is more than that of neutral and live. A backlight is being used, okay, which is provided to prevent shock. Safety precautions for using electricity. We should not operate the live wires with a wet hand, and make sure that it has an insulation. And all the naked wires, means wherever the connections are being made, make sure that you're putting then tape around that and insulation above that. And the appliances should be properly earthened. And we should keep in our mind that the fuse which we are using, that is of having a proper rating. That means we are using a light or fan or geysers or heavy loaded appliances. So accordingly to that, we have to use the current carrying capacity wire, whether it be 5 ampere or 50 ampere wire. So color coding, as we know, there are the three wires in any transmission wire for the live, earth and neutral. According to old convention, we are using red for live, black for neutral and green for earth, right? Now this has been changed. Now according to modern color coding, we use for live we use brown, for neutral we use light blue, and for earth we use green or yellow. But previously this is being used. In order to carry high voltage and heavy current and for longer distances, we use high tension wires. In this high tension wires, there are thin wires which is being twisted together in order to increase the large surface area. And what are the characteristics of tension wire? Due to large surface area, their resistance is low, and next, it is non-corrosive. Okay, so these are the characteristics of high tension wires which we use for long distances. High voltages, if you need to carry out to long distances, we use this high tension wire, in which thin wires is being twisted together and it provides a large surface area. Due to large surface area, the resistance becomes less. As we know, resistance is directly proportional to rho L by A here. That means resistance and A, they are inversely proportional. If the area, if the thickness of the wire is less, then it will increase the resistance. But if the thickness of the wire is more, then resistance will be less. So in high tension wire, the thickness increases here, that because of large surface area, therefore the resistance decreases. So this was all about household circuit.